Hello dear students, welcome to the accountancy class. What we are learning today, we are going to learn how to create the compound journal entries. Now what do you mean by compound journal entries? These are the entries which you are doing collectively. Okay, so that in one day only you are making some transactions which are of similar nature. So instead of making separate journal entries for each transaction, you will make only one entry for that. So the combined entries is called as a compound journal entry. Okay, all the theory I will give you in detail. So what we are going to study today, we are going to study a 12 marks question. This kind of questions they do ask into exam regularly. In last year's paper also it was asked. This question is from last year's midterm question paper. Okay. In here only journalize the following transactions in the books of Srikanth. Srikanth aur pustakadalli en madri ee journal entry ee transactions ige journal entry madri. So you can see how many transactions are there. 1 2 3 4 5 and 6 transactions are there. For each correct entry you will get 2 marks. In this way this question comes for section D for 12 marks. Okay, so let us start. What is the first transaction? See, the first transaction is for 1st August 2019. Commence the business with cash rupees 1 lakh and furniture rupees 20,000. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಾಕತ್ತಾರು ಶ್ರೀಕಾಂತ್ ಅವರು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯಾರು. ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಬಂದಾರು ಮತ್ತ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಅನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಬಂದಾರು. ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲಿ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್? 3 ಅಕೌಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್. ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ದ 3 ಅಕೌಂಟ್ಸ್? ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್, ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಕಮೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್, ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್, ಬಿಗಿನ್ಡ್, ಇನ್ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟೆಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ? ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯಸ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಅ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ದ ಡೇಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 01/8/2019. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್? ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್, ಸೊ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್. What else is coming in the business? Furniture is coming into the business. Therefore, furniture account debit. Both these are real accounts. Real account pe the niyam apply aate hai ki debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So they both are coming into the business. That's why debit. Two, who is the giver? The owner is the giver. So Shrikant's capital account. Shrikant's capital account. What is the amount? See, amount is equal to rupees cash 1 lakh, furniture is rupees 20,000, and what is the total amount that is brought? The total amount is 1,20,000. So give the narration for this transaction. Being commenced business, being commenced business, the narration should be always short, simple and meaningful. ಏನೇನ್ ತಂದಾರ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ? ಅದು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣಕತ್ತೈತಿ. ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ತಂದಾರು ಮತ್ತ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ತಂದಾರು. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ 2 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ಬರು ಶಾನೆ ಬುದ್ಧಿಜೀವಿ ಏನ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರು, ಮೇಡಮ್ ನೀವು ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಹಾಫ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಸರಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀರಿ, 1 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಸರಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀರಿ? ನೋ, ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಫುಲ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ತಪ್ಪಾಯ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ರಾಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, so yes, let us go for the next entry. What they are saying, see, bought goods from Ganesh 30,000 and Lokesh rupees 25,000. So ili new yen tilkobeku that the nature of the transaction is same. Only when the nature of the transaction is same, then only you can do it as a compound journal entry. So ee transaction alli nodri eradu kade navu yen madakattivi, kharidina madakattivi. So here the nature is of purchases, then only you can do the compound journal entry. So from whom you are buying? From Ganesh and from Lokesh. Nowhere it has been mentioned that it is a cash transaction. Okay, ellu spashtate idinda helilla that cash vannu kottu avu dudu idu goods vannu kharidi madakada. So ultimately it's a credit transaction. What is coming in the business? See, goods are coming in the form of purchases. So which account will be debited? Purchases account. On what basis? Debit what comes in. So purchases account is a nominal account or a real account? It's a real account. Okay? So purchases account debit. Two. Yar kadeyin khareedi madidri? Ganesh avar kadeyin khareedi madidri for rupees 30,000. Mattu Lokesh avar kadeyindano idar date ge khareedi madidri. So the date also needs to be same. The nature of transaction also needs to be same. Then only you can do a journal entry. So from Lokesh, how much you have purchased of 25,000? So what is the total purchases? The total purchases are 55,000. Give the narration. Being made credit purchases. Being made credit purchases. Or you can also write down being bought goods on credit. Both will be same. So, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಬ್ಬರ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ನೀವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ನೋ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಓವರ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಶೋನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಯಾರ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಖರೀದಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಖರೀದಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಖರೀದಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಓಕೆ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ನಂಬರ್ 3 ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ರಾಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಹೀಮ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಇಬ್ಬರಿಗೂ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತಾರೋ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತಾರೆ Again, what you need to understand is nowhere the cash has been mentioned. So obviously, it's a credit transaction. So, yav accounts bartav nodri illi, which accounts will come? Identify sales, Ram and Rahim. Sales is a real account. Ram and Rahim both are personal account. Okay. So sales and goods are coming in or going out? Going out. So should I put debit or credit? Credit. Who are the receiver for these goods? Ram and Rahim both. So receiver again hakri, debit hakri. Put down the date 10-8-2019. So which account will be debited? Ram account will be debited. For how much? For rupees 35,000. In the same way, Rahim account also will be debited. For how much? For rupees 15,000. Two. What is being done here? Sales is being done. So what is the amount? Amount is equal to rupees 50,000. Give the narration. Being sold goods on credit. Being sold goods on credit. So if like this neatly and systematically you are writing, for each journal entry you are going to get 2 marks. Now let us go for the next transaction. What they are saying, see, paid to Ganesh in full settlement of his account of rupees 29,500. So Ganesh avrige neevu en madidri full settlement alli payment madakottidri. Nenapidli, whenever the word comes full settlement, ultimately the discount account is coming. Okay, so write down the next journal entry for the date 15th August 2019. So when you are using the word paid, it means what is going out? Cash is going out. Yavaga vakyadalli paid received anta shabda bantandra cash transaction aitha. Okay, so cash is going out. Who is the receiver then? Ganesh is the receiver. So debit the receiver. Ganesh account debit. Iga Ganesh avrige neevu eshtu debit hakbeku nodri, illi eshtu credit biddaitha avrige ashte debit illi hakbeku, which is equal to rupees 30,000. Two cash account, two discount received account. Discount received account. Okay. So now see, how much is the cash that you are paying to Mr. Ganesh? It is 29,500. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಲಕ್ಷ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಕೊರಿಲಿ 30,000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕೊಡುವುದೈತಿ. ಅದ್ರಾಗಿ ನೀವು 29,500 ಕೊಡಾಕತ್ತೀರಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದ್ರಾಗ ಸೆಟಲ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತೀರಿ. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಯು ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪೇ ಎನಿ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್. ಈ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ಮತ್ತೇನು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ನಿಮ್ದು ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಏನಾಯ್ತು? ಶುದ್ಧ ಆಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ 500 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಏನಾಯ್ತು? ಓಕೆ, 500 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಉಳಿತಾವ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ what is this 500 rupees? It is the income for the business. Hang ait income helri, 30,000 koduditu 29,500 ashta kodagatira andre 500 rupees ulisidralla business salavagi. So this 500 will become the income, and income are to be credited according to the nominal rule. Okay, so write down the narration. Being paid to Ganesh being paid to Ganesh in full settlement. In full settlement. Now see, whenever they have told you to journalize, you compulsory in marbek nodri aa page the total haakalebeku. So write down total carry forward and see what is the total. So the total is equal to rupees 2,55,000. Okay, this same total should be brought forward for the next page. Okay, so as I have lack of space over here, what I will do, I will rub this and I continue here only. Okay, now let us go for the next transaction. First of all, write down the total brought forward. So the total that is brought forward from the previous page is 2,55,000. Okay, now let us go for the next entry, entry number 5. Okay, what is the next date? See, date is 25th August 2019. Yen received cash from Rahim rupees 14,500 and allowed discount rupees 500. So it is first thing helakatar nodri, received cash, simply received from Rahim helakatar nodri, what is received, cash is received, so therefore cash is coming in cash account debit. How much cash is received? 14,500 is received. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವಾಗಿನ ಅವ್ರಿ ಏನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರಿ. ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ತು, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೂ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ, ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತೈತಿ. ಮುಂದಿನ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ದುಡ್ಡು ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರ ಮತ್ತೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರ ಆಯ್ತಪ್ಪ ಇದ ಸುದ್ದ ಆಯ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಯು ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಲೌಡ್? ಸಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ರುಪೀಸ್ 500. ಟು, ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದ ಗಿವರ್? Rahim is the giver. So write down to Rahim account. So what is the amount that is totally received from him? It is 15,000. Pratyakshavagi dudd andru 14,500 na bandaiti. Idu enaiti full settlement ad entry. So here the 500 difference will be considered as discount allowed by Srikant. Okay, give the narration. Being received from Rahim in full settlement. Okay, now let us go for the last entry, entry number 6. Yen helakatar nodri, paid manager salary 10,000 and rent rupees 8,000. So what is the nature of transaction here? Again, you are making a cash transaction and you are doing the payment of the expenses. So the nature of transaction is same. ಎರಡನೇದು same date ಗೆನ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. And that's why you can do compound journal entries. It will save your time. Okay? So therefore, write down the entry. Paid ಅನ್ನಕತಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ cash ಬರ್ತೈತಿ, ಹೋಗ್ತೈತಿ. Then, what should be debited? The expense account. Okay? So here, what will be debited? The manager salary account will be debited and rent account will be debited. Okay, so write down manager salary account debit, rent account debit. To yen kotri cash vannu kodakuvi. Okay, so is the amount that you are paying? See, the amount that is being paid is 10,000 for the salary and 8,000 for the rent. So what is the total payment that is being made here? It is 18,000. So give the narration: being paid for expenses. Okay, what are the expenses? They have been shown into detail into your journal entry. ಈಗ ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಟೋಟಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ, ಇಟ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎಸ್, ಯೂಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 288,000. ಓಕೆ, so in this way you have to prepare the compound journal entries. Are they necessary? Yes. Are they important? Very much. Will they come into the exam? For sure. Okay, so ultimately you have to learn it. Okay, we shall take one more question in this class itself. Yes. So what we have done, see, we have taken one more question which is related to compound journal entries. So let us start the question. What it says: on March 2019, Salman starts wholesaling business and record the following transactions. Okay, so whose books are these? These are the books of Salman. When the transactions are taking place, they are taking place in the year 2019 for the month of March. Okay, so let us start with our first transaction. Madalay transaction yen hirtid nodri, he started business with capital rupees 15,000 and land worth rupees 10,000. So again you can see this is a compound journal entry where more than two accounts are coming. Yalli eradikinta jaasti accounts irtavu anta journal entries ige now compound journal entries ant karithu. Okay, so therefore what is coming into the business? See, he started business with capital and helagatar. So capital andre na yenu? Cash. Okay, so therefore write down for the first journal entry for the date 1 what is coming into the business. Cash is coming in, so cash account debit. What is the amount that he is bringing? It is rupees 15,000. Along with cash, owner yenen tagon bartano adu ellarku na capital anna helthu. ಡೆಟರ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟರ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಮಷಿನರಿ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಮತ್ತೇನ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಬಂದಾರು ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಬಂದಾರು, ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್. ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ಸೊ ರಿಯಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅದ್ ನಿಯಮ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ, ರಿಯಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅದ ನಿಯಮ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೈತಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್. ಟು, whose capital account it is? It is Salman's capital account. New bare capital account baradrunu nadideyi. Okay, you can just write down simply as capital account, no need to write down the name of the owner because already it is mentioned on the top, this is the business of Salman. Okay, so Salman's capital, if you do not write, is it fine? Yes, but you have to mention it as capital account. Now what is capital account? It's a liability. Okay, because what is the amount, the amount invested by the owner is called as capital, and when the business is winded up or closed, that time this amount should be given back to Salman, and therefore it is a liability. Okay, so write down, it is 25,000. Narration bariri, being started business. Being started business. Okay, let us go for the next transaction for 08. What they are telling, see, bought goods from Bilal and friends for rupees 1,000 and buy cash from XYZ company rupees 2,000. See, pay attention very much. Bought goods from both. Okay, so the nature of transaction is same. Ibburu kadeyinda en madagathiri, purchases anna madagathiri, but one is a credit transaction, another one is a cash transaction. So you have to be alert. When there is a credit transaction, you are going to write down the name of the person. But when there is a cash transaction, you will not write down the name of the person or the firm. Okay? So, what is coming in? Goods are coming in the form of purchases. So, write down purchases account debit. Two, first we are buying it from Bilal and friends. So, you in other country, creditors other. Bhavishyada good bed taru. Yadak bed taru, you over kade purchases madiri, but amount auri pay madila. And therefore, we are showing them into the credit effect. So, they will become the creditors. That is a liability for business. And that's why the credit effect. Or, you can also say Bilal is the giver. And that's why credit the giver. So, write down Bilal and friends account. Amount is rupees 1000. So, Bilal khareedi ashtu khareedi madidi 1000. Adhe reethi inda cash kottunu khareedi madidi. Yaar kadeyin khareedi madidi x y z. So, when there is a cash transaction, no need to write down the name of the firm. Only when it's a credit transaction, you need to write down the name of the firm. Okay? So, how much is the cash that is paid here? It is rupees 2000. So, what is the total amount of purchases? 3000. 1000 is credit purchases and 2000 is the cash purchases. Okay? So, write down the narration. Being bought goods. This much only is enough. Being bought goods. Okay. By looking at the transaction itself, you can understand that from Bilal it is on credit and here there is a cash transaction. Okay. So, journal entry number 3 and the date is 13. What they are telling is, sold goods to Rahman and Sons for rupees 1500 and sale by cash rupees 5000. So, again the nature of transaction is same. In both the transactions, there is a sales. But one is a credit sales, another one is the cash sales. Then too, we can make it as a compound entry. Okay? So, let me tell you why and how we can make it a compound entry. Salka nimigi torustini. So, illi, yerada transaction bantha notari. Yen helagutara avaru sold goods to Rahman and Sons ant helagutara. Okay? So, who is the receiver? Rahman and Sons are the receiver. Aurige en kodri debit kodri. Yes, debit kodtiri 1500 the debit kodtiri. 2 en madidri sales ant madidri. How much is the sales? 1500 is the sales. Narration en baridiri being sold goods on credit ant baridiri. Correct. Avattin date ge na same date ge na mattonu sales agiti, but this is a cash sales. Again, what will be the journal entry? Cash is coming in. Correct. Why cash is coming in? Because new goods vannu mari. The sales is being done. For how much? For rupees 5000. Okay. Now this is a transaction which has taken place on the same date, 13. And the nature of the transaction is also same. Sales, sales. So instead of writing two journal entries, what we are doing, instead of writing two journal entries, we are preparing only one journal entry. So, Rahman and Sons will be debited, cash account will be debited, and the sales account. Instead of writing two times sales, we will write down only one time sales and we will add up the amount. So, this is how we need to prepare the compound journal entries. Why we are doing so? In a business, so many transactions will be there. You cannot go on writing the journal entries if they are having similar nature. So, to reduce your work, this kind of shortcuts will be adopted. Okay? So, let us write down the journal entry for this. Rahman and Sons account debit. Then, cash account debit. Two, sales account. One month benefit, the nature of the transaction should be same. The nature of the transaction same iddag matrana you compound entries madak sadhyate aithe. Okay, one sales aithi mattond purchases saithandra compound entry madak baragilla. Even if the transaction has taken on the same date, avaag neevu en madbekagutti separate erdu journal entries na madbekagutti. Okay, so what is the sales done with Rahman and Sons? It is 1500. The sales for cash, it is 5000. And the total sales is 6500. Give the narration. Being sold goods.
being sold goods. Okay.
Now let us go for the next transaction. Transaction number 4 for the date 17. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಗೇವ್ ಅವೇ ಚಾರಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್, 50 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ದಾನ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾರು. ಅಂಡ್ ಮರ್ಚಂಡೈಸಿಂಗ್, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಮರ್ಚಂಡೈಸ್? ಮರ್ಚಂಡೈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಗುಡ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಫೋರ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 30. ಬಾಸ್ಲಿ ಹಿಂಗ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಹೋಲ್ಸೇಲ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಐತಿ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೇ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಐತಿ, ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಬೇಡವ್ರು ಬಂದು ನಿಂತ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ದಿನ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಅವರಿಗೆ ದಾನವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಬಟ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಅದು ದುಡ್ಡು ಹೊಂಡೈತಲ್ಲ, ಗುಡ್ಸ್ ಹೊಂಡವು. So every penny should be recorded into your business. Then only you are a smart businessman. So new goods are kodri, cash are kodri. Okay, it is called as charity. So idu illi andre first helabittaru. Donation ant bandandre new donation account hakabodu athwa charity. Usually donation word is used when a huge amount is given. Then we write down the word donation, donated ant. Okay. But when there are micro or very small, small charity work that you are doing, write down the charity account. Okay? So, write down charity account debit. What you are giving? You are giving cash. And then you are giving goods. So, remember here. Hinta vandu na madhu madhi nodri. Okay? Yavag nyo goods kodagathi. Adan nao sales and consider madak agani. We can neither write down stock. Stock can be written only when the valuation of stock is done at the beginning or end of the accounting period. So, nadu niu yenare goods vannu kodakattiri, adu personal use salvagare irli, danad salvagi irli, gift dagi irli, yen bekkadevi. Okay, so then it has to be shown into the purchases account only. Yakri madam ri purchases account anna baribeku, niu bandid rate yena kottiri. Agdi yen nimugu free man antu bidilala, niu yen kottiri. ಫ್ರೀದಾಗ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಪೇ ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ರಿಕವರಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್? ಸಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಈಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 50, ದೆನ್ ಮರ್ಚಂಡೈಸ್ ಈಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 30. ಸೊ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಚಾರಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 80. ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ನರೇಷನ್, ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಚಾರಿಟಿ, ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಚಾರಿಟಿ, ಚಾರಿಟಿ ಅನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಂದು ಇದು ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಪೇಜ್ ಮುಗಿಯಾಕತ್ತೈತಿ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್. ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೇಜ್, ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಪೇಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 25,000 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 3,000 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 6,500 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 80. So which is equal to 34,580. Okay, 34,580. Now this same total should be brought forward for the next page of your journal book. Okay, so as I have this much only space, I am rubbing it and writing down here. You can mark it next page mele bari. So what we are doing, we are taking down the total for the next page. So total brought forward is 34,500 in both the columns. This is compulsory. See, if you do not do, I'll cut the marks. Okay, now let us go for the next entry. The next entry is entry number 5. Okay, for the date 21. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಪೇಡ್ ಬಿಲಾಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 975 ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 25. ಸೊ ಪೇಡ್ ಅನ್ನಕತ್ತೀರ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ, ಹೋಗ್ತೈತಿ, ಹೋಗ್ತೈತಿ. ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದ ರಿಸೀವರ್? ಬಿಲಾಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಪನಿ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆರ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫರ್ಮ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಲಾಲ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವ್ರ ಫ್ರೆಂಡಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾರಂತಿಲ್ಲ, ಹಿಂಗ್ ಹೆಸರಿಟ್ಟಾರ ಅವರು ಅವ್ರ ಶಾಪದ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಬಿಲಾಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್,
discount amount.
See, here I am going to give you one tip. Cash ಗೆ debit ಬಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ discount ಗೆ debit ಅನ್ನು ಬಿಳ್ತೀವಿ. Cash ಗೆ credit ಬಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ discount ಗೆ credit ಅನ್ನು ಬಿಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಇಷ್ಟು ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ನೆನಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. So what is the amount that is being paid? 975. How much is the discount? Discount is 25. So what is the total amount? See, it is rupees 1000. Give the narration. Being paid in full settlement. Being paid in full settlement. Okay. Now let us go for the last transaction for the date 28. Received cash from Rahman and sons rupees 1450 and allowed him discount rupees 50. Now see here. Again, whenever the word discount comes, you have to remember the tip that I have given. Received under what received? Cash received. So write down cash account debit. Debit what comes. How much is the amount? Amount is rupees 1450. Okay. ಯಾವಾಗ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇನ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಈಗೂ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಬೀಳ್ತೈತಿ. ಸೊ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್. ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಲೌಡ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 50. ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದ ಗಿವರ್? ರೆಹಮಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಗಿವರ್. ಸೊ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ದ ಗಿವರ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್? ಸಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 1500. ಓಕೆ, ಗಿವ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾರೇಷನ್. ಬೀಂಗ್ received cash in full settlement. Being received cash in full settlement. Okay, full stop, bracket complete, and do the total. Okay, now total is compulsory. See, if you miss writing the total, 1 marks will be taken away. So now use your calculator and tell me what is the total. So the total is 37,000. Okay. So in this way you have to do your compound journal entries. Parikshadalli inta lekka bilthavo for sure bilthavo. Okay, so I hope all of you are understanding my classes. We shall continue in the next class. Thank you.